You're listening to the audio production of Language That Leads, Communication Strategies That Inspire and Engage by Kasia Wezowski, published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by Jill Blackwood. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperfocusaudio.com.
Foreword. A leader's communication has ripple effects throughout an entire organization and can be the deciding factor between the success or failure of even the largest companies. No matter our jobs, we all face situations in life and work when we are called upon to lead. And when those moments happen, our communication style becomes more critical than ever. I believe every effective leader needs to learn fluency in the language of leadership. Leaders who speak this language not only have a positive impact on others, they also elevate the way everyone in their organization communicates with one another, resulting in better understanding, less resentment, and drastically improved results. My friend Alan Mulally understood this. Alan took over as the CEO of Ford Motor Company in 2006 at a time when the company was losing billions and the stock price was plummeting. Alan's turnaround of the company is regarded as one of the great corporate success stories of our time, and it began with communication. Alan deployed a no-defects approach to communication, insisting on politeness and treating others with respect and consideration at all times with no exceptions. If a cell phone was used during a meeting, the meeting was stopped. If someone made a sarcastic remark, that behavior was quickly corrected. The intervention began at the top, and Alan ensured it was witnessed by people at the company at all levels. By modeling considerate communication, the entire corporate culture changed, and success followed in its wake. Leaders need to be especially sensitive to their communication because their position of authority means that even the smallest verbal or nonverbal cues can have enormous impact on their staff. For example, I often caution leaders against using the word but because this three-letter, one-syllable word can have a disproportionately destructive impact on the results of your communication. When the word but follows positive feedback, it tends to erase the emotional impact of whatever came before it. If you tell someone, "You approach this project with care, insight, and diligence, but the finer details need some more refining," all that the person will actually hear is, "The finer details need more refining." Imagine that whatever you said after the word but is the only thing the person hears, and you'll understand the true impact you are having. This example highlights the difference between good communication and poor communication. When you are communicating well, what you say is the same as what someone hears. And when you are listening well, what you hear is the same as what the other person is saying. Today, more and more leaders are also called upon to manage knowledge workers. These are professionals and subject matter experts who know more about their particular field of expertise than the people managing them do. Telling things to these people is not enough. To be an effective leader, you also need to be able to ask and be able to learn. Peter Drucker is the founder of Modern Management and was my mentor for many years. Peter had a knack for knowing where management was heading long before most managers figured it out. When Peter said, "The leader of the past was a person who knew how to tell. The leader of the future will be a person who knows how to ask." He was referring to an idea that forms the core of Kasia Wezowski's book, Language That Leads. Communication as a leader in today's world has three phases. Number one, asking for input. Number two, understanding input. And number three, responding to input. I can summarize this formula in four words: ask, listen, think, thank. To be successful at this, you need to be able to accept what others are saying to you from a place of genuine openness and curiosity. This means getting beyond your ego and exercising a certain level of self-control. As Frances Hesselbein, the longtime CEO of the Girl Scouts of America, says, "How can you be expected to control others if you can't control yourself?" As Kasia explores in this book, great communication is not simply something you do. It's not just a few behaviors that can be memorized and imitated. It's also a deeper level of understanding of yourself and the careful cultivation of qualities that will help you earn the right to lead and direct other people. Leadership is a way of being, and it is also, as this book explores, a holistic language. When you understand the language of leadership, both when listening and when speaking, you will be able to ensure that you are successful across the entire spectrum of your communication. Whether you're a corporate executive, a startup founder, a parent, spouse, or someone working your way toward the top, there are moments in your life when you are called upon to seize the mantle of leadership, whether for a moment or for years. And even outside of those special moments, the keys to communication that are explored in this book will help you shine and facilitate others to shine as well. The result will make you not only better at communicating to others, but also better at receiving communication from others. Marshall Goldsmith is the Thinkers 50 number one executive coach and New York Times best-selling author of The Earned Life, Triggers, and What Got You Here Won't Get You There. Introduction. There's an internal struggle happening within every leader. A leader wants to be perfect. At the same time, perfection is impossible. It's not even always desirable. Perfection means that nothing can or should be changed. It refers to a permanent state. Leadership, however, is fluid. It is something that you need to live day by day. Leaders may be able to create perfect systems, but the human element will always introduce the need for change. Therefore, true perfection can never exist. Leadership as a kasuri pattern. To understand how imperfection is actually the source of great leadership, I like to think about kasuri, a type of Japanese fabric design and patterning. Kasuri is a fabric that has been woven with thread fibers carefully dyed to create interwoven patterns. The designs look splashed, blurry, imperfect. This smudged look is not an error. In fact, it is inherent to the beauty of the kasuri patterns. Once, the royal family in Okinawa attempted to create a kasuri pattern that was perfect, with straight lines and perfectly aligned patterns. The result was a piece that was clean, but could not be called kasuri. It lacked the beauty of the classic smudged patterns, and so the quest for perfection was abandoned. In The Beauty of Everyday Things, author Soetsu Yanagi explains how the imperfection of kasuri, its smudged effect, is not a flaw, but rather its very essence. Without this rubbing or smudging, kasuri could never have been. It is precisely this misalignment and blurry effect that is the source of kasuri's beauty. Creating kasuri requires a special process under specific conditions. The process is carried about by humans who will inevitably make some mistakes. But within the context of this process, mistakes and errors actually enhance the resulting beauty. Leadership is, in many ways, the same. No system you create will be followed by perfect, identical robots. The human element will impose itself and make itself evident through small differences. How you manage these differences and master this subtle interplay of forces will determine your success as a leader. According to Inc. magazine, most companies only operate at 30% of their potential. In Language That Leads, we will look at how you can become the kind of leader who can harness the human factor to raise the potential and performance of individuals and organizations. Inspired by Marshall Goldsmith's people-centered leadership philosophy and informed by my own experience as a student of human nature through the study of micro-expressions and body language, we will explore how you, as a leader, can place yourself in alignment with the people who make up the systems and organizations that you work with. Leadership as communication, not command. Leadership used to be synonymous with authority. Leaders would give orders and others would follow. Not anymore. In today's dynamic business culture, leadership is about facilitation, not force, communication, command. Leaders of the future need to use their empathy and influence to bring out the potential of their employees and let each individual shine. To stay relevant in this new reality, leadership training is long overdue for an upgrade. Language That Leads is a practical guide for growing into a leader of the future. Through clear advice and real-world examples, you will discover in these pages how changing the language you use and improving the way you communicate, not only with others but also with yourself, will result in greater engagement, efficacy, and impact across the board. Each chapter in this book is based around a core quality of leadership, as identified by Marshall Goldsmith. We will explore each idea in practical detail, explaining how it can be expressed, observed, and projected through both verbal and nonverbal communication. From specific, powerful techniques to big-picture principles, you will discover how to measurably increase your impact as a leader of organizations and people. Here's a sneak peek of what you're about to learn. New leadership. Why leaders of the future need to be different from leaders of the past. Micro expressions. How reading these brief flashes of facial expression is the key to understanding and interpreting the honest emotions of others. The body language of leadership. What your posture, gestures, and stance say to others, and how to control this. Feed forward, not feed back. Marshall Goldsmith's approach for how successful leaders communicate. Emotional intelligence. How to effectively manage others as a facilitator, not a dictator. Intuitive decision making. How effective leaders trust their empathy and make decisions from the gut. Blink. My signature technique for interpreting someone's true feelings about a situation or idea in under 2 minutes by observing body language and micro expressions. The leadership mindset. How to think and therefore act as a leader. Values-driven leadership. How to lead with integrity by tuning in to the core values that drive individuals and businesses. The book is divided into three overarching segments: outer skills, which you display and perform, inner skills, which you embody, and growth skills, which will impel your holistic evolution as a leader and also as a person. Each chapter will cover an essential leadership quality, such as adaptability or empathy. We'll explore how you can recognize this quality in others and display yourself congruently with the whole spectrum of your verbal and nonverbal communication. Each chapter will cover the following elements: why this leadership quality is important, how you can nurture this quality in yourself, how you can observe this quality in others, how you can make your body language congruent with that quality, how to recognize this quality using the blink technique. Having been inspired by Marshall Goldsmith throughout my career, it is an enormous pleasure and privilege to be able to introduce his wisdom to you here in these pages. Combined with my own experiences and expertise, the result is a journey into the heart of what it means to be a successful leader in today's world. I am so excited to be able to embark on this journey with you now. Kasia Wezowski, September 2022. Note: there are many moments when this book asks you to rate an attribute on a scale of 1 to 10. You can find visual scales in the accompanying PDF for those evaluations. Part 1. Outer Skills. Chapter 1. Adaptability. In The Earned Life, a film exploring the legacy of Marshall Goldsmith, Goldsmith stresses the idea that the job of a leader is not to be the smartest or most impressive person in the room. It's to get the best out of everybody in order to have the best team possible. During the film, Goldsmith takes a moment to reflect on a simple Buddhist idea. Every time I take a breath, it's a new me. This is, in Goldsmith's view, true for each person. People are constantly changing, so each time you come to a meeting or introduce a new person to a team, you must be able to adapt in order to get the most out of each person's skill set. Only when you are able to develop this kind of adaptability will you finally be able to create the best team possible. Why adaptability is an important leadership quality. Change is one constant that any business can count on. The worldwide pandemic of 2020 was only the latest reminder that adaptability is essential for a person or business hoping to ride out the daily, monthly, and yearly changes. While the recent pandemic may feel like the biggest change businesses have faced, the last 30 years have actually seen businesses become less stable due to economic instability. The changes can't be stopped or delayed, which is why it's crucial to develop adaptability as a leader. Adaptability may feel especially important when facing changing external circumstances, but it's about more than this. It's about adapting to people as well. When you work as the leader of a team and are able to open yourself up to the emotions of those around you, you may observe that people are constantly experiencing changes within themselves, including changing emotional states. By learning to navigate those states, you can improve the quality of your team's work. The importance of communication. Communication is what will allow you to get clarity from those around you, which will help you adapt to changing circumstances. Conveying what you want from people and how you want it done is essential. Adaptability also involves welcoming communication from the other person, including how they feel about a task, how motivated they are to fulfill what is demanded of them, and what they would like to bring to the table. Being open to their ideas can help you know exactly what needs to be changed in order to get the most from their skill set. Being a leader is no longer a one-way street. To be truly successful as a leader, you must build a two-way street that will allow people to come to you with ideas and feedback. Managing secrets. In The Earned Life, Goldsmith speaks with Alan Mulally, former CEO of Ford, U.S. CEO of the Year, and Fortune's No. 3 World's Greatest Leaders. Mulally describes how he adapted to his team by creating a system he calls Managing Secrets. The system involves three colors: green, yellow, and red. If the members of his team showed a green board, it meant that they saw no problems and were good with the plan. Yellow meant they saw an issue and had a solution. Red meant they saw a problem but didn't have a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.